I just think over the years to the great champions, the ones who defined what bodybuilding was. And it's just grown and grown, and that's the source of bodybuilding is growth. That's what we're all after, and no one can doubt that the Olympia has been a massive success.
Everybody that saw me going through everything I went to, I hope that inspired you to know that quitting is not, you know, an option.
It is a milestone event for the Olympia. 50th, it's a big figure for all of us. And it's really breathtaking to look back to the first Olympia in 1965. By chance, that's when I got involved in following bodybuilding. And the first Olympia, there were only three guys in it. There was no prize money. Larry Scott got a crown. The next year he got $1,000. Fast forward to this year, and the prize money in total across all classes is 1.1 million, and the winner gets 275,000. And we have an expo. Nobody would have known what an expo was in 1965. When AMI took over in 2004, the expo had like 200 booths. Now there are 1,100, so that the whole event has just grown and grown, and that's the source of bodybuilding is growth. That's what we're all after, and no one can doubt that the Olympia has been a massive success.
Olympia men and women, I dare to have a dream of being on the Olympia stage one day, being at this press conference, you know, maybe even being the last man standing on that stage one time. There's going to be all kinds of people in your life that are going to tell you you're not big enough, you don't have the genetics, you don't have what it takes, blah, 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 blah. Let me tell you something. No man has a right to tell another man he can't do something, period. And so if you want it, you just gotta go get it. Believe in yourself, find a way, overcome.
And as I sit here thinking about it, you know, remembering the first one, I wasn't there, I was only a kid. This isn't even pre-Arnold day, so that shows you how far back we're going. I just think over the years to the great champions, the ones who defined what bodybuilding was. First of all, really, Sergio defined a new look with his round muscle bellies and just humongous size. Then along came Arnold, who, the most successful bodybuilder, one of the most successful men of all time, who just dominated with his V-taper and biceps and chest that have never been bettered. Frank Zane brought in a new look in the late 70s of refinement. Then along came Lee Haney in 84, who, this was the biggest man we've ever seen, and he started the period of the big men winning, followed by Dorian Yates, who redefined mass. Then came Ronnie Coleman, who dominated his era with his version of mass. Jay Cutler, you know, showing that you can fight your way up from way back and win the Olympia four times. And now we have a current champion, Phil Heath, who is possibly the best of all time, who has got more detail than anybody builder we've ever seen, ever.
But I'm here to tell you, I believe in myself. I believe in, you know, my sponsors, my family, my friends, and my fans. You know, I give them all the respect in the world.
The great thing about the modern Olympia is it's a melting pot. Everybody's here, not just the competitors who are competing, but competitors who haven't made it or retired or amateurs. So you get to see old friends every year. I'm looking forward to seeing guys that I came through with in the 70s and the 80s, particularly Barry de Mays coming from Holland. He's not been for 20 years. He was the glamour boy of the 80s on all the covers, Holland's best bodybuilder. Rich Gaspar is another one that I always meet up on a yearly basis. Lee Haney. And then you see faces that you weren't expecting to see. And the real camaraderie and the brotherhood of bodybuilding comes through as you recount the old tales and think of old times and old spats and controversies. Sama Binu, 1983 Mr. Olympia, is another one who, back in the day, 80s and 90s, me and him used to go at it all the time, even to the point of almost coming to blows. Now we're like two old guys sitting on the porch in rocking chairs, laughing about what got us so upset in the old days. It really is, you know, you look back and it's been a hell of a ride, and it's been a hell of a ride for bodybuilding and the IFBB.
Okay.
of course, with the background of the spat at the press conference and what happened last night with the pushing and shoving and the face-to-face stuff, we had a really dramatic contest with a story in it. And I think the result was right at the end. I think at the end, Phil just had too much, but a hell of a battle. I've seen every Olympia since 1982, apart from 89 and last year. And out of all those nearly 30 contests, the one that really stands out in my mind is the 1988 one in Los Angeles. Partly because it was in the home of bodybuilding. It was the first time it was held there. It was held at the Universal Amphitheater, a great theater. And I went to Los Angeles 10 days before. And in those days, Goals was the mecca. You would go in the morning, and there would be Mike Quinn training, Gary Strydom training, Rich Gaspari training, Barry DeMay training, Robbie Robinson training. All these guys were in Olympia. You'd go in Goals and see those guys. Then you go across the street to World's Gym, and you'd see Tom Platz, who wasn't competing, but he'd be training. Ralph Muller was there, who was competing in that year's Olympia. Bob Paris was there. And Arnold would come in two or three times a week. And then later in the week, Haney came into Goals, and it was like you had almost the lineup in front of you. And then on the day, in this spectacular auditorium, really the apex, it was the height of posing excellence. Everybody posed well. Lee Haney, Gaspari, Barry DeMay, even Mike Quinn. It was like a perfect storm of a show. Bob Paris did a magnificent routine. Phil Hill did the best routine I've ever seen to Phantom of the Opera, even though he wasn't in shape and got 11th. So the whole thing felt good because of the home of bodybuilding, and everybody really came in at the best. And it was just a moment that I always, when anybody says to me, what's your greatest Olympic memory, it's always 1988.